Ton 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 ton.
Giant clams belong to the Tridacnidae family, which comprises of 10 species. They are generally found living in the shallow waters of the Indo-Pacific coral reefs. What makes them so unique? Well, to begin with, giant clams are the largest known bivalves in the world. The largest individual to have been recorded was over 1 meter in length and weighed over 250 kilograms. The clam's massive stature can be attributed to its symbiotic relationship with zooxanthellae. These photosynthesizing algae live within the colorful mantle tissues and satisfy a large proportion of the clam's nutritional needs. Giant clams have long been a traditional source of food and ornament among Pacific peoples. In recent decades, drastic declines in natural populations and even local extinctions have occurred due to poaching for food, ornaments, and the aquarium trade. In spite of this, giant clam research is focused on enhancing its potential in commercial farming, with much knowledge of the clam's behavior and ecology left in the dark. As with many other large organisms, myths and legends surround the giant clam. Past scientific and military publications even once wrote of man-eating clams claiming lives. Such extravagant stories stemmed from our active imagination and a lack of understanding of these creatures. As you can see here, no harm is done to this brave soul's hand. The tendency for giant clams to close their valves quickly is no more than an act of self-defense, rather than a provocative, life-threatening attack. So much for these killer clam myths. However, the misconceptions don't end here. Assumptions that these gargantuan animals are sessile for life are fairly common. And indeed, it is difficult to imagine movement in these giant mollusks. Many marine invertebrates associated with coral reefs start off microscopic in size. The giant clam is no exception, beginning their life journey as a tiny pelagic larvae no bigger than a pinhead. Watch how this larva senses its environment before inching its way along with its foot. This organ is developed within a few days of fertilization and is essential for activities such as crawling and substrate sensing. For many pelagic larvae, habitat recognition is crucial for development and protection. Many studies have shown that crustose coralline algae, amongst other physical and chemical factors, are a positive cue for larval settlement. A choice experiment found that high concentrations of crustose coralline algae attracted giant clam larvae towards suitable sites for settlement. However, this settlement cue does not seem to be important for older larvae. Is it a thing? Crawling is not the only thing these giant clam larvae can do.